Hi, my name is Gala. I am a looker expert, and today I want to share my experience about Facebook connectors to Looker Studio. It is not about Facebook connectors. I would like to share my experience how I pull Facebook ads data to Looker Studio dashboard, because I can see several options how to do it. Definitely, you have other ideas and try other options, because there is no only one correct way to do it. I just share my experience and I hope you will like it. So let's go. You have Facebook ads, you have Looker Studio dashboard, and you want to show your data. This is our case. Logically, the easiest way how to do it is add data to the dashboard. Let's do it. I click here. Okay, this is my test dashboard. It's empty and nothing interesting. So how do we start? We have a search box and we type Facebook ads. Google connectors, 0. It's normal because it is Google connectors. It's one company, Facebook, it's another company. So we don't have free Google connectors for Facebook ads. But we have list of, 75, it's a lot, partner connectors provided by different companies. How I do it usually? In this tail, we have title, then we have by Supermetrics, by Funnel, by Power My Analytics, and so on, and some description. If I don't know which to choose, I go to provider website, check prices there, check fields there, because why we can choose different connector services? First of all, we have, for example, we have different combination of metrics and dimensions, and they grouped in different ways. So mostly I work with Supermetrics. I think from these companies, it's one of the most expensive connector services, but they are like leaders on the market and they work on this market for many years. So they're more stable. They provide nice scheme, like nice combination of metric and dimensions that fit for mostly all cases. And they have normal service desk. So if you have some questions, you can ask them. And I work as well with Power My Analytics. I like these connector services. They started later than Supermetrics, as I know. And 3 years ago, they were super cheap, but they didn't have nice. They wasn't stable, so it wasn't too stable. Now. In 2022, I already use them a lot, and they became more expensive, but the quality is much better. So it's twice less expensive than Supermetrics. They're stable, but they have not so comfortable metrics and dimensions to work with. And some charts you can build only with Supermetrics. Some charts you can build only with Power My Analytics. They have different combinations. So they take from Facebook API different fields. But there are different, like Funnel, I didn't work because it was too expensive for my clients, so I didn't have chance to work with. But get started with our free plan, I don't try it, maybe I should. So, but there are some other companies like Report Dash. I did some reports with them. I didn't continue to work, probably was some reason, but anyway, Reporting Ninja, I heard it. I think it's about not so convenient, as I know. So there are different providers. Datafon, I had good reviews about these connector services. So try a lot. You can check them. You can check what fit for your needs, and that is it. So let's try to connect data. I'm not sure that I can do it from this account. When you connect it first time, we have a bottom out race. Okay, this is free because, every connector services, they have free trial. Usually it is 2 weeks free trial. So I selected Supermetrics as I know it. First of all, I did authorization to Supermetrics, and they created account for me, and my trial started. Then I can, yeah, this is choose an account in Supermetrics, and yeah, I click allow. There will be Facebook authorization. I'm not sure that I have any Facebook ads account here, actually. But yeah, okay. Next step is Facebook ads authorization. Let's try it. Okay, if I don't have it, it's fine. Okay. Okay, start. Connect to Facebook ads. So on this tab, we connected our Facebook ads connector to our Supermetrics account. Then we have some cookie. Then I have some. Okay, I don't know. I can't log in here, I think. Okay, I will not log in now because I don't want to share my data. So you can do Facebook authorization. Okay, let's do pause here. I entered my password, and here I have this authorization window where I can continue as my account. Okay. And at this point, this window should closed. Okay, connected successfully. My connection, I can see my team, my Supermetrics team, and my Facebook ads account. This application was created, blah, blah, blah. You can close this window. When I connected my Facebook ads account, I can select some account, for example, Gailey Reports. Probably had some ads there, let's see. Then conversion window, I recommend to have default, report time of action starts, and blah, blah, blah. And then I just add it to my Looker Studio dashboard. And basically, that is it. You have connected your Facebook ads account. You can create any, okay, ad report. You can create different charts, some tables, and you have this Facebook ads account in your data sources. Okay, I didn't have any ads running in December, probably last year. Probably I did some ads last year. So it's my test account, so probably, yeah. Anyway, it's connected. You have some metrics and dimensions there, like the same with Google connectors. And yeah, I spent some money, yeah, had some campaigns. What interesting here, you can add even add creative image here. And this is nice point from Supermetrics connector that they have add creative images. I think Power BI Analytics, they have it already as well, but I'm not sure about other connectors. These pictures field, not all connectors have it now. Okay, when I checked it, none of them had it. So you can add, you can see a real picture of your image, and it's super interactive and it's super cool, I think, for dashboard to see. Even you can see like split by Facebook and Instagram by platform. So anyway, this is the first option how to pull your Facebook ads data to Looker Studio dashboard, direct connector services. Pros and cons. It's why it is good, because it's simple. You just add data, you have all data coming automatically, and it's super comfortable. But why it is not, sometimes it is not the best solution, because you have to pay for connector services, and but anyway, you have to pay. But your report could work slow, For example, if Facebook ads, they updated their API, and they do it quite often, Supermetrics team have to update this their API as well, their services, and sometimes you can see broken charts, like some errors that data is not coming or something goes wrong. So second point and third point, data coming in real time. So it's a huge process, and if you have a lot of charts on the page, it will work slow. It's fact. It's super comfortable, but it will be slow. And I didn't find any way how to make it faster because you pull data on real time. And another point that it couldn't be super the best option, if you have like Facebook ads, Bing ads, Google ads, whatever, and you want to show the total cost, total impressions, do some calculations, you have to use blend data. It works, but it could be tricky to set up, and you could have some errors, and it could be complicated. So the next option that we can use, it is check which, a data source. We have Google connectors, and we can use as a platform, as a middle layer of our data floor. It could be Google Sheets or BigQuery if you have a lot of data, or if you have your data in your MySQL database, you can connect this one. So the most common case is Google Sheets. Super easy. In this case, let's create. Go to Sheets. In this case, how does it work? We can create Google Sheets, where we pull our Facebook ads data, and then we connect this Google Sheets to Looker Studio. Okay, how can we pull data to Google Sheets? First of all, we can go to Facebook Ads account, select some data range, select some create tables there, and just download CSV file and put this CSV file to your Google Sheets. It's manually, but it's free, and if you need to create accounts once per month, to create reports once per month, or even once to show, to present some result of one campaign, it will be fine. You just set up dashboard in Facebook Ads, copy to Google Sheets, and connect to Looker Studio. Perfect. If you want to update data daily basis, we can go to extensions, add-ons, get add-on. The same logic as Looker Studio. We can just type here, Facebook ads. And we can see list of connectors. We can see a list of connector services. They provide options to pull data automatically to Google Sheets. Here you can find other providers or same providers. It's more tricky, I will tell you honestly, it is really more tricky than pull data to Looker Studio directly. But let's observe Supermetrics just to show you, because I mostly I work with Supermetrics for Google Sheets. First of all, we do individual install. We install this add-on. My video looks like Supermetrics advertising, but my point is it is not necessary to use Supermetrics. Mostly, like, Looker Studio connectors more or less are the same. Google Sheets connectors could be tricky, but anyway. Okay, we installed. Here we have, in extensions, we have Supermetrics. Here we can do launch. When we do launch, we do authorization, and we can pull data here to Google Sheets, set up different tables, schedule it as we need, and that is it, and just connect this Google Sheets to Looker Studio. As option, okay, this is two options how to pull your Facebook data, or even three, Google Sheets, direct connector, Google Sheets manually, adding data, Google Sheets with connector that pull data automatically, and I think the most complicated way to pull data is App Script, because Facebook ads, they have open API, and if you know how to work with APIs, you can write your own script. I'm not sure that you need it, actually, as for me it's easier to pay for some services, but some services, they don't have normal connectors, so sometimes you can write your open API's App Script to pull, connect to API, even pull data via script. So I think that is it. I feel this video became too long, and this is a huge topic. Maybe I will try to move to film other videos more specific about Supermetrics connectors or Power BI Analytics connectors. Let me know if you are interested in this topic. And yeah, give me a like and see you soon.